Nicknamed the Punisher, Rodrigo Duterte is a Harley-riding former city mayor who speaks his mind. Duterte! The president of the Philippines appears to have a questionable grasp on international diplomacy.
I am a president of a sovereign state. Putang ina, mumurahin kita dyan sa forum na yan.
Referring to US President Barack Obama in profane terms, leading to the White House cancelling their bilateral meeting in Laos Monday.
The president.
One day later, a statement of regret that this may have come across as a personal attack, followed by a claim the obscenity was directed at the journalist who asked the question, not Mr. Obama.
I have seen some of those colorful statements in the past, and so clearly he's a colorful guy.
Add to that Duterte's homophobic insults to the U.S. ambassador to the Philippines less than a month ago. It's fair to say the historically close relationship between the U.S. and its former colony may have taken a hit. But it's his domestic policies that have many more worried. He cruised to victory back in May, vowing to get tough on crime and corruption. Few realized how tough. An intense crackdown on drug pushers and users, giving police a license to kill.
Resistance is violent, thereby placing your life in jeopardy. Shoot and shoot him dead.
Over less than 10 weeks that Duterte has been in power, police have killed more than 1,000 people, allegedly in self-defense. Many others registered as deaths under investigation, a term that may include vigilante or extrajudicial killings. Human rights groups are horrified. The president has branded the senator leading an inquiry into this increasingly bloody war on drugs an immoral woman. Duterte came to power on an anti-establishment ticket, tapping into strong disillusionment with those in power. His welcome in Laos Monday night shows he still has strong support. In fact, back in July, his approval rating was 91%, according to Pulse Asia Research, a figure most other leaders can only dream of. Paula Hancocks, CNN Seoul.